Good afternoon, everyone. In preparation of this day, I had two associative thoughts that I want to share with you. As a way to pose some opening remarks and questions for the conversation that we will be having about art as political commitments. First, I was reminded of this documentary I saw a while ago about the Ateliers, this very prestigious art academy located in the center of Amsterdam. Who of you has seen it? Any of you? A very beautiful and at the same time very disturbing documentary I found. The Ateliers receives thousands of applications per year and only a few lucky ones get in. Those who are accepted are destined to make it in the art world, to become highly successful artists, and to see their work becoming in high demand on the market. In the documentary, we see a number of brooding young people. They receive the keys to a huge, beautiful, white atelier space with enormous windows and lots of light. Several of them become instantly depressed as soon as they have settled into their ateliers. They don't know what to do with all that space and all the possibilities to fill it. Most of all, they don't know what to do with themselves. They get lost in their own introspective musings. The pressure of expectations and the pressure to perform highly clearly becomes too much. It becomes clear that only the real talents, who cannot do otherwise than answer their artistic calling, will survive. This documentary shows that a certain classical image of what it means to be an artist is still alive. The best works are produced in complete solitude, while the artist is detached from the hustle and bustle of the outside world. A higher aesthetic level can be reached when one is not distracted by worldly problems. The Ateliers functions as a monastery, where one's personal struggles with inner demons and the transcendental muses of inspiration can be fought out. It seems to be a place where the artist most of all needs to develop its own sense of self in order to create a perfect artwork. This image, as it is presented in the documentary, opens up questions about the autonomy of art and the position of the artist. Can the quality of art only be valued if it is created from an outside position, offering innovative aesthetic and conceptual input which originated at a distance from the social and political sphere, and which is only later publicly shared with the audience? Now, this most certainly is not what Matthijs de Bruijn is doing. Today we will engage in a conversation with Graciela Carnevale, the Argentinian artist who has inspired Matthijs in important ways. She is best known for an artistic intervention or action which she made in 1968 named Acción del Encierro, or a confinement action. She invited people into a space which functioned as a gallery that day, shut the door and locked her audience up without any warning. She forced her audience to literally break free from the gallery space by shattering the glass of the windows. In my eyes, this action illustrates almost the opposite of what the Ateliers stand for. Here, it is not the artist who locks him or herself up in solitude in order to come to a meaningful product, but she locked her audience up and thereby made her audience complicit in her work from the very start. By forcing the audience into action and trapping them inside the center of her work, she broke open the static image of the gallery space, or the museum, where the audience normally remains a passive and thereby also an innocent onlooker. She thereby experimented with art as a social action that has a direct impact on its environment. By confronting her audience with the violence of enclosure, she critiqued the repression of the military dictatorship that was ruling Argentina at the time. It is not the belly button gazing, as we say in Dutch, individual internal struggle of the artist that is central to her work, but the felt urge to engage in an intersubjectively shared social struggle. Both her work and Matthijs de Bruijn's work offer interesting entry points to explore how the boundaries between the insider and the outsiders to social movements and art institutions can be complicated, blurred, or broken. Now to my second associative thought. I was reminded of a poem written by the Spanish poet Gabriel Celaya in 1955, also at a time of repression by military dictatorship. The poem is entitled La poesía es un arma cargada de futuro. Poetry is a weapon charged with future. In the poem, Celaya curses poetry which is made like a cultural luxury for those who wish to remain neutral. It's here on the screen. I'm not going to read it because it's in Spanish and I have a horrible accent when reading in Spanish. So for those of you who can understand, you can read it while I talk. Poetry is a weapon charged with future. In the poem, Celaya curses poetry which is made like a cultural luxury for those who wish to remain neutral. He speaks of another kind of poetry, which is not clean and polished, but stained by a commitment beyond personal suffering, like a worker's tool. This poetry for the poor is not well thought out, drop by drop, nor is it a beautiful product or a perfect fruit. However, it is necessary, like the air we breathe, or our daily bread, as Celaya says. It keeps people alive and sets action in motion. Now, this image of art as a weapon charged with future, a kind of art that might not always be aesthetically pleasing and which is both committed and compromised, because it deliberately and directly takes sides within social struggle, is related to Matthijs's work as I see it. I hope that today we can together think through the potential of art which is aimed at imagining other options, another possible future, exactly by looking beyond the kind of internalized personal struggles I saw in the documentary about the ateliers, and opening itself up to a commitment to social and political struggles in a direct alliance with others who find themselves in precarious positions, with workers, with migrants, with students. We will discuss what artist commitment implied for the generation of 68 and what it might imply for us today. We will discuss what the consequences of artist commitment are for the autonomy of art and how artist commitment might or might not relate itself to social movements and institutions in and outside of the art world.